Hey, what's up everybody? My name is TrophyNut, and welcome back to Dark Souls 3. Last time, I ended up quite unexpectedly at this cathedral, and I had to go somewhere personally. So that's why the episode ended so weirdly. But today we're going to continue our quest into Loptrick. There seems to be someone over there in a chair, which kind of reminds me of Maria in Bloodborne. But I also wanted to note that there are these creatures that we saw in the beginning cinematic. These, wanderers with those shells chained on their backs. They seem to be all dead. But this place is riddled with them. Since I don't really have any Estus left, I will not enter the cathedral right away. Because I'll probably die anyway. But I do want to look around a bit. So we're back at the high wall of Loptrick. And there's one knight over there. Might want to lure one of those over here. Hello! Oh shit, that might have been a problem. Wanna backstab you. Thank you. That's one. Oh shit, I can hear someone firing at me. Go. Taken care of. And then this guy. Are you? Ooh, that was a dodge too much. And the buttocks. There we go. Okay, didn't drop anything. Anything of interest over here? Aside from all the dead people, what does the message say? Grab a hat, by the way, be wary of frost. Oh man. Oh man, oh man, oh man. Let's turn this up to get my focus points. Oh no, 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 no. That was great. Wanted to do that. So what else do we have here? We have one more place that we haven't checked yet. Well, aside from all these dead fellows. Anything over here? Nope. Okay then, let's check back upstairs. There is one other knight over there, which I might be able to fireball to death anyway. I'm gonna wait until he turns around. Maybe I can even backstab him. Oh, nope. Here you go. Sorry, dude. You died. Okay. No secret walls yet. Illusory walls, I mean. I've been saying hidden and secret walls. I mean, ooh. Fake walls. Nope. 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 Still nope. Okay. I'm gonna check out that Lucerne I got. A polearm with a sharp, hard, pronged head that inflicts thrust attacks. The Lucerne is wielded overhand like a hammer, or can be swung from the side to break through shields. And a spin sweep is its special attack. So the rest, I think I checked all that. Although I didn't check this one, I think. A well-crafted straight sword designed for thrusting attacks, wielded by the venerable knights of Loptrick. The Knights of Lothric with their drakes once crushed anything that threatened their shores. Of course, that was a long, long time ago. So these Lothric Knights actually use dragons to attack. Interesting. And why can't I use that? There we go. Ooh, 18 dexterity. I'm gonna have to start boosting my dexterity a bit. Oh. Hi. Will you hear me? Are you evil? Oh, for shite. Ooh, he looks very evil. That was a nice block. I'm dodging way too far. He has way too much range with that. Why is this sword all shiny? Ow. Yeah. That said it all. So that guy kicks ass. Okay. We can get back there pretty quickly though. Since we have that shortcut over here. I'm gonna pretty much try to ignore half of the people here. Hi! Yeah, okay. I only half killed myself there. Oh, hi! No! Okay. That guy just set off the elevator. I was trying to be too fast there. Time for rolling indeed. I did want to try something. For those moments where I have the time to do this. I think if I two-hand this. Ooh. I do get a slight buff of healing health regeneration, as you can see. But I didn't want to have my axe back. Doesn't do that much, but it's something. Ho-ho-ho. Did he just jump on my head? This isn't Mario, you know? So let's get the Ashen Flask, get a few shots back, and my souls! I do want my souls! Wait, did I get another Estus charge that I didn't have before? Try stabbing in the back, no shit Sherlock. So let's try this again. So he's pretty much the same guy, didn't backstab. Woo! Die, dude, die. Ooh, motherfucker. A knight's crossbow. Interesting. So let's quickly check that out. There we go. Crossbows, crossbow used by the Proud Knights of Lothric. It bears an elaborate gold design. The crossbow has been blessed with the power of lightning in anticipation of the use of lightning bolts. Okay. So that's a lightning? And I can use that. So I might be able to use that against the dragon to kill that thing, but first I am doubting whether I should try to kill that blue knight again, since I failed 2 times already, but this is Dark Souls. Gonna have to retry a few things once in a while. So closer, 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 touching! That wasn't fair. Yes. Yes. Oh, fuck. Fuck you! In the face! Lothric Nightshield. Okay, I hope that thing is fucking better than what I'm carrying right now. Heal! Yes, thank you. Finally. And it's not a fucking boss. Okay. So I'm gonna use a Homeward Bone to get back to the bonfire and use those 5,710 souls before I enter this place. Then I'm gonna check out that shield first. And I really apologize for that fucking mess. So I can't use it. 18 strength needed. Shield of the renowned Lothric Knights, decorated with a royal crest. The Lothric Knights contended with dragons, and their shields have suitably high lightning absorption, befitting a dragon slayer's arms. Okay, it's a repel, so I can parry with it, but it's 100% physical, and a lot of lightning defense, so I might boost my strength up to that to be able to use that shield. And then after that, go into dexterity. But first, use to the shrine so we can level up immediately. That's handy that we can do that straight to the shrine. Okay, back at Firelink Shrine. Where is the level up? Nope. That's not what I wanted to do. I wanted to sprint, but that's circle.
Welcome home, Ashen One.
Thank you.
Speak thine heart's desire.
I want to level up.
Very well. Then touch the darkness within me.
And I hit my controller on the desk.
Take nourishment.
Yeah, okay, we get that. So strength is now at 13. I need 18 for that shield. So we might as well spread this out a bit. Intelligence is pretty good around now, so attunement is where I want it to be. So maybe one more in strength? Yeah, let's confirm that.
Farewell, Ashen.
There we go. And then I would like to buy some crossbow bolts from you. Although that sorcerer staff would be nice as well. Is this physical 100? Is there a physical 100 shield in her inventory now? Wooden Bolts. That's by 72 of those. And that should enable us to kill that dragon. So let's go back to the high wall of Lothric and kill that dragon. And then we'll enter the cathedral. So travel. Which one would be closer, actually? I might even... Well, let's go to the high wall. Okay, so I'm gonna quickly check if I can equip another weapon already. Oh, I can use that Astora straight sword. Well, I'm more of a sword guy than a axe guy, so might as well do that. I think I'm gonna use the crossbow. No, let's wait until we reach the dragon. Wow, it looks amazing from over here. Okay, so that's the swords. It does have a bit of a long windup. I think there's one behind me now. Oh yeah, there he is. Oh, and the dodge attack. It's a stab, okay, so a thrust. And the heavy is also a thrust. There we go. And then we'll see about the rest in a second. There's still one behind those boxes, right? I knew it, and I got still hit by it. Go. An iron round shield. Maybe that is a better shield. It's better. It's also a bit heavier. I'm gonna use that for now, since I'll be able to block, well, 10% more. Because that's the main reason why I don't generally use my shield, because it sucks. It really does. It sucks, monkey balls. I get out of the way for the dragon breath. And stab the back. So I think I might be able to get to his face from over here. And there goes another one. So I'm safe around here. Dragon will take care of everything else. I have standard and wooden bolts. So let's try this thing out. So two hand. Oh, I can bash. Ah, there we go. So... doesn't seem to hit him. Oh, I did hit him now. Maybe... I wonder if I can hit him from under there, so I'm gonna wait until his next fire breath. Yeah, there we go. So let's run, and then the only thing we need to be careful about is that we're gonna need to fight that one knight again. Except... would he attack me over here? That didn't really do anything. How do I switch bolts? I don't really know how to switch bolts. There we go. So if you guys know how to switch bolts, let me know. Okay, I can hit him over there. Oh fuck! Oh fuck! Oh fuck, oh fuck, oh fuck. Didn't expect him to do that. Whew! That was, spectacular. I don't seem to be doing that much damage, honestly. Yep, I got you figured out now. For fuck's sake, am I safe around here? Because I'm gonna clear out that one guy over here. I do like the sword a lot better. So let's get back to shooting this thing. Oh, I do get hit. Okay, I do get hit. But how far do I get hit? In the butt. I am wondering, is there a safe spot for his attack? I'm fucking terrified right now. Well, that does a pretty big amount of damage. Yeah, I'm dead. So that wasn't a safe spot. So I might have to go back and get a few more bolts, because I don't think I'm going to be able to kill him with what I have. So let's go to Firelink Shrine. Now she's sitting over there. Let's use a few of those consumable souls. How much does that give me? Let's use two of those. And let's see how many I can buy with that. So bolts, 60 more. Oh, I can only carry 99. That was a bit of a waste, but hey. Let's travel to the high wall again. How far can I stand while not getting hit?
need to find a position. Yeah, okay. Wild damage. So I don't think I'm gonna kill this thing. Nah. This is lost stuff. I'm not gonna even kill this thing. So breed on those fools, and I'm gonna head up. Get my souls back. Oh, it was quite a bit. Whatever. So the last thing I want to check right now before we head to that boss again, because we can't kill that dragon apparently. So from here, I'll probably get my souls back easier. If I wouldn't suck monkey balls, of course. Okay, he goes downstairs. So I can get my souls back. And now we haven't been downstairs here. There he is. Try aiming at the enemy you're trying to kill. Jesus Christ. Okay. Let's just heal up a bit. We haven't been here. There's a big guy with a halberd over there. And not anymore. Titanite shard, okay. Ah, another elevator. So is this a completely opposite way of heading somewhere? I see someone over there. It does seem to be one of those normal dudes. Okay, so this seems to be some sort of storage area. Throwing knives. I still hear stuff. The mail breaker. Can I go through here? No. Well, that looks like a nice shield. More throwing knives. The mail breaker, a small sword made for thrusting attacks. This hard-edged sword can pierce through tough armor and boasts a deadly critical attack. Shield splitter, aim carefully and attack in a large forward lunge to pierce through enemy shields and inflict damage directly. Okay then. Okay. We seem to be back outside again. Praise the key. There's a cell here. Let's go check it out. Anyone guarding this cell? It's locked. So there's someone in there. I'm gonna have to try to free that man. There doesn't seem to be anything else around here. Okay. Because I can't go through here. So I'll probably have to go up and try to reach and around, because there have been a few rooms that we haven't been in yet. When we died again and again. Not that this was any different right now, but... Charge! So now I do want to kill that guy. Nope. Nope, nope. So this here is the place I was talking about. And there's another item over there. No, 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 no. Okay. So I'm gonna leave that guy over there and then... There should be a knight here. Okay, he's over there. Oh, fuck. Did he backstab me? Oh, come on. Note to self, guys with bandit knife can backstab you. Get my souls back. Kill that guy. So down here is that cell then, I presume, because... Oh no, right over there, yeah. So that's where the cell is. Now we only need to find out where the key is. Hi there! The butt. Ooh. Lothric Knight Longspear, Lothric Knight Armor, and Leggings. Let's check it out. Some Lothric Knight Longspear, designed for long-range thrusting. Lothric Spear Knights are known for their steadfastness, and this spear boosts the poise of its wielder. Hold spear at waist and charge at foe. Use strong attack while charging to extend the length of the charge. Okay. And then the armor. The Lothric Knight armor. The Code of Distinction is all but fallen apart. The knight has served as one of the three pillars since ancient times. Three pillars. And shares place alongside the wyverns as a symbol of Lothric. Only those possessing a knight's resolve are fit to wear this garment. And the leggings, yeah, pretty much the same. So if I the equip load would be the same. Oh no, wait, let's go to equipment and try comparing those. Yeah, it's a lot heavier, of course. Maybe I can carry the leggings. No, would go way over, so I'm gonna keep my pyromancer gear for now. So let's see. Last time we went into this little thingy and we were fucked. So right now, hi. I think I died because of this guy last time. Yeah. So there we go. And a broadsword. Large sweeping attack makes this effective against crowds, but is prone to deflection from walls and narrow spaces. So I'm not gonna use it, I think. It's not that much better, I think. Let's compare. Would be a bit... Oh no, it's worse. Okay, so I'm gonna keep the Astora straight sword for now. Anything else here? So we're back outside for a little bit. And then we're in the room that I got face raped in. So this time I should be careful and only lure out a few guys at a time. Hello there. Yeah, why not? What? What the fuck? What? What? Oh, come on! And I'm back where we were. Here, doggy, doggy, doggy. That's the dog. I'm gonna first take a look around here. Chest ahead. Yeah, indeed. First gonna kill that guy. There we go. And I don't trust chests. There we go. Silver Eagle Kite Shield. That sounds amazing. Oh, thank Christ. 100% physical reduction. Equip. Look at that beauty. So now I can block attacks and not receive any damage from it. Let's take out the guy with the axe first. There we go. So now we're overseeing that big guy, and he has seen me. Nothing here. And nothing here as well. So the only thing we need to do is kill that halberd bastard that killed me last time. Oh fuck. So that's one dog. Whew. I need to block. I forgot that. I still didn't block. What's this? Looks important. Estus shard. Oh yes, thank you. So that means we can add another charge to our Estus flask. There's nothing here. But this is quite a big room, so I'm gonna look around a bit. There's something over here as well, Titanite shard. Would I be able to... Well, I would be able to, but... I'm wondering if I would dare already put a few upgrade points into this sword I'm using right now. I kind of like it, but I'm guessing I'm gonna find cooler things later on. Selkie! Oh! Okay, okay, Selkie. That's great. So let's head straight back there, because it doesn't seem to be another way around here. That's just that balcony. Yeah, yeah, it's the only way, apparently. So let's head back up and around and try and open that cell. So let's try this. So I can block. Took a lot of stamina, though. Yeah, that makes things a lot easier. Okay. Well, that was great. So the only guy over here is one of those hooded fellows, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah. So those things do blow up. So he missed the last time. Is there anything here? Don't think so. So now I can open the cell. Let's have a little chat with this creepy hooded executioner guy.
You're no jailer, are you?
No, I'm not.
No, no, you're from far away. And judging by the bell, you must be some of that enkindled ash. Remarkable. If that's true, then I have a favor to ask.
Unkindled ash.
Below the high wall is a musty little town. Not the home of any lord. Just a very old settlement of undead. An old woman, Loretta, lives there. Please, give her this ring. I'm not asking for charity. In fact, if you do this for me, I'll be sure to repay you in kind. Okay, I may be a petty thief, but I've more wits than most royalty.
Okay, then.
What do you say, then?
Okay, I'll help
you. Very well. I humbly place my faith in you. I am Grey Rat of the Undead Settlement, and I promise to assist you.
Great.
Give this ring to old Loretta at the base of the high wall. Do your part, and... I'll do mine.
Okay. Oh, a blue tearstone. Where the hell did he go? Blue tearstone ring. Add rings. A ring set with a large rare tearstone jewel temporarily boosts damage absorption when HP is low. The stone is said to be a tear of sorrow of the goddess Keta. And of course, tears are always more beautiful near death. And the ring of sacrifice, I forgot to show you that one. This mystical ring was created in a sacrificial rite of Velka, the goddess of sin, so that's still the same, I think. Its wearer will lose nothing upon death, but the ring itself breaks. A sacrifice is only worth as much as the life it spares. So, I might as well equip the ring of sacrifice then. Since I have 4 ring slots. Where did he go? Any hidden... illusory walls in his cell? No. So, I think that's all of the areas I didn't check upon. If I missed any, let me know. And I think that's most of it, except for the area below the dragon, which I'm gonna get to eventually. Does this open? No, it's still locked. So that must lead to that undead settlement. So let's get back up the stairs here. and I'll warp first to Firelink to use my souls. Yeah, let's do that first.